got into our personal life, all I saw was her. I could only see her. I didn't see anything else that was going in the room. All I cared to do was look at her.
He certainly does. I put a lot of thought and caring, and he puts his whole heart and soul into something. If he's going to do something, it's going to be done 100% all the way. No holds barred. Passionate about everything he does, from, you know, loving me and his family and anything else he's doing, his work. You can see it, you know, with every ounce of his being. That's just who he is. He has a lot of intensity.
Mary is so energetic. She finds the good in everything. She loves to have fun. No matter what we're doing, I mean, we could be riding on a boat or just sitting together listening to music, she's content.
He's full of surprises, you know, around every corner there's a little surprise from him. And it's always fun and interesting. He keeps it interesting. He's very gregarious and outgoing and the life of the party. You know, he wants everyone to have a lot of fun. He's such a giving person. He's always doing something to keep life interesting and fun, not just for himself, but for everybody.
She's very soft. I like touching her. I like just being next to her and being in contact with her. She finds the best in everything. When you need someone, when you love someone. Before we met, was the toughest time in my life. I was having serious thoughts about whether I wanted to still be in business, and I really had taken on some big responsibilities. Suddenly, here comes this offer from an independent real estate agent.
I used to call people all the time on the phone, looking for people to buy and sell real estate. So I actually had called him up, and I knew he had some property, and asked him, you know, if I could sell his property, or if he wanted to buy some properties that I had, some, you know, sellers. And actually, that's how we first met. He gave me a listing.
And she made an offer that basically would get me out of it without making any profit, but would relieve me of the pressure.
And then we started talking for about a month.
After a number of emails, I finally called her. And I said, I wanted to talk to her about it.
Yeah, it was in the summer. We started talking and we found out that, you know, you sound familiar. Where are you from?
In talking to her, I was starting to see something or feel something that was very familiar.
Actually, I was from Ohio, and he was too, I found out.
And I said, I can't believe it. I said, I knew there was something about you. It took me a while to get up the nerve, because I just wasn't feeling very confident myself. I finally asked her if I could, you know, if she would go on a date with me.
And basically, what he said to me that really turned my head on the phone was that he goes, well, how do you know I'm not your soulmate? And I said, I don't know that. No man had ever said something like that to me.
And I didn't know what to expect. So I walk up to the front door. And remember, I've seen Mary only in the webpage on her business. When she opened that front door, all I saw was blue.
I like the color blue, so I wore a blue dress. Yeah.
Blue. She had blue eyes, a blue dress. In her house was blue carpet. You know, I saw blue, and it was not what I was, you know, it wasn't what I was expecting to see from the picture I saw. It was definitely what I expected to see in how I was speaking to her on the telephone.
And it was sort of like I looked at him like, you know, wow, I felt. Because he had said something to me about being soulmates, and I don't know, I'm saying, are you the one? You know, it really hit me.
She offered me a glass of wine, and then we went out on our first date.
And then after that, everything went smoothly, and, you know, I had fun at dinner and all of that.
So we had a very nice evening, and then when I dropped her off, I just gave her a little peck on the cheek, because I'm still feeling I wasn't sure, you know, how to approach her. I asked her out for lunch, and we went to a sushi place, and we ended up eating lunch for it seemed like 3.5 hours.
We closed the place at 3 for lunch. They're like, well, are you guys ever leaving? You know, we close at 3 and open at 5 again. So we went back to my house.
It was 5 o'clock in the afternoon. We ended lunch.
And we sat there and talked for 2 hours, almost an hour and a half. And he looked at his watch. Oh, I get back to work. I go, it's 4:30, you know, it's like going back to work. So he's sort of sitting there, like I was sitting on one end of the couch and he was on the other. So we sort of started moving together. He started moving closer to me. And that's when we had our first kiss.
That's when the fireworks really went off for me. I mean, they really did. I got in my car and I just couldn't believe it. I went back to work, but I wasn't able to do anything.
Oh, it was fun. You know, we kissed and I go, and he's like, I have to go to work now. And I go, okay.
And then when I got home, I just had to call her. It was just an amazing feeling to me to have that first kiss with her. And I've always remembered that feeling. Music. The music was music I had heard, but it didn't have that much meaning to me, and some of the music I hadn't heard before.
I always played a lot of jazz, all types of music, from Van Morrison and Stevie Ray Vaughan, he had never heard of, and Van Halen, I mean, just you name it, you know, Joe Cocker, and I was playing all these different types of music that's, you know, more from the 70s, 80s, I guess.
And frankly, you know, we were doing so much talking on the phone that we would just sit there and just listen to music, and suddenly all of the words in the songs had all this different meaning to me. And we would just sit there and listen to music and just be together. It was really, really special.
I guess he would go home and the next day he'd have a new CD. He'd burn a CD for me.
I was buying this music one song at a time because each song had a special meaning to me. And then I started making compilations of this music.
And it was really a lot of fun for him, I believe, to start looking into music because Tony is a very analytical person and he likes to have fun. So he really got reintroduced to music, I think.
Then when I would leave her home, I would turn on the compilation, I would listen to the music, and I would just savor for the 9 miles from her house to my house. I would just savor the moment, you know, because of being there. Sometimes I'd get home and even call her.
He just enjoyed being at home and spent a lot of time together, and it was really great, you know. The trip to Laguna was one of our first time to go to Laguna.
I felt like I couldn't do enough for it.
Went to this nice Italian restaurant, and they had a little three-piece band combo.
And I got up and I started singing That's Amore.
He's got the hanky and twirling it around, singing. And he,
you know, That's Amore, you know, singing like that. And
we had a great time dancing, and everyone there was clapping, and everyone was hooting and hollering, and we just had a really fun time.